Mark, you said in the announcement just a few minutes ago that we need more heroes. Now, you have both done things in markets where there were vacuums, that somebody else wasn't doing it. What's the vacuum here? There is a Nobel Prize.
Mm-hmm. Well, I just think that society has a lot of heroes for a lot of different things, but we don't have enough heroes who are scientists and researchers and engineers. And these people are just doing great work, the people who won these prizes today. And you know, what we're trying to do is we're just trying to set up this institution and do what we can from the sidelines of that work to reward and recognize the amazing stuff that all these folks are doing to cure diseases and expand our understanding of humanity. And improve all these people's lives in different ways. So we feel like that if we can recognize that work, then it can inspire a lot more folks to do similar work as well.
Mark, so you've got Anne, and you've got Sergey from Google. You've got Art Levinson from Apple, chairman of Apple. You've got Yuri Milner on this group that has financed a lot of companies that you might actually think of as competitors. This is sort of the face of the new technology. You're not all people who normally work together, certainly in business. You're kind of competitors.
Yeah, I think all these companies actually work together a little bit more than people think. But the big thing here is that, you know, science and technology are very closely related. And, you know, when you're building these information technology companies, the market rewards you and you can make a lot of money. But a lot of these folks who are doing just such extraordinary work in science don't have the same opportunity. And because of that, I think it would just be a shame if a lot of folks who are growing up trying to figure out what they want to do now don't choose to go into such critical work because of that. So if by having these prizes, we can give an incentive and can kind of make some of these folks a little more well-known as figures that some younger students want to grow up to be like, then we're doing our job here.
Right. You know, Ray Kurzweil's talked about how in 15 years, every year we'll be adding a year to how long we can live. You just mentioned living to 100. That's actually fairly common now. And we know that of kids born today, many of them will live to be 100. How much can we extend life, and how much should we extend life, in your opinion?
You know, you're asking questions that are a bit above our pay grade, I think. But
I'm not sure there are a lot of people in the world above your pay grade.
The work that these folks are doing, I mean, they're each taking big risks and taking on these big projects,
right.
But each of these is a step forward for humanity, right?
Yeah.
So, I mean, these questions about where we're going to be in 10 and 20 years, they're important, but I can guarantee you that people who are sick or who might have these issues want the cures that these folks are working on building. And in order to get more of the best people and the smartest people who are going through school today to work on these problems, to help cure these diseases, I really hope that the work that we're doing here today can just be an institution, the signal that's
meaning,
an inspiration.
Meaning, you talk
to a lot
about
of folks.
Like the Nobel Prize or things. It's a thing. People talk about the breakthrough prize. Somebody got awarded that,
yeah,
and that's
think
a big deal.
You know, this prize isn't really about the people who are winning it today.
Right.
It's about the college and grad students who are, you know, in the lab trying to figure out what they should be researching.
Yeah.
It's about younger kids who are still trying to figure out what they want to be when they grow up.
But how does this fit into a Facebook world in 5 years or 10 years when this thing is a really big deal?
Oh, it doesn't. I mean, there are things that I focus on Facebook because I think it's a really good thing for the world. I really believe in our mission of helping people connect and making the world more open and connected. But there are lots of things that I think would be awesome to see exist in the world that Facebook isn't the right vehicle to work on those things through. And it's awesome to be able to work with a lot of folks who are really smart and have been successful in other areas and draw on their experience to do things like this as well.